I also have the feeling that because a number of issues have been taken into the high-level segment and have been linked to each other, that we're in a way in a kind of all-or-nothing situation, in that if we don't manage to get the work done in time on the future, then the whole house of cards basically falls to pieces. If the house of cards falls to pieces, what we will be moving forward with basically is clarity in terms of the formal negotiation on future commitments of industrialized countries, because that'll just be the so-called AWG continuing. But you could well end up in a situation where there is no clarity on the future process, there is no clarity on the Article 9 review, and there is no clarity on technology transfer. The whole launch of this negotiating process will have its foundations in the convention and is therefore intended to enhance implementation of the commitments of the convention, and in other words is trying to make operational the commitments that different countries, including developing countries, have taken on under the convention, to make that operational by putting technology and financial resources in place. So in fact, I would argue that if we don't manage to launch negotiations on the future here, then all that you have left is the formal discussion about industrialized country commitments, and meanwhile the first commitment period of Kyoto is coming to an end, and there is no forum for discussion on what should follow on beyond. So I think it's imperative actually for all countries to realize that progress on the future is in their interest here. And I think everybody, including the United States, has come here with the stated desire to formally launch negotiations. And I think that it'll be incredibly difficult for any politician to leave here and go back home and explain that he or she has provided no political answer to what the scientific community has been saying. I think that that's what's at stake for everyone, including the United States. The US have indicated that they feel that including numbers now would prejudge the outcome of the process. Others, for example, the European Union and a number of G77 countries, would very much like to have the numbers in. if the numbers remain in one form or another, then we will have achieved more than I had expected out of this meeting. I had expected a formal launch of negotiations, agreement of an agenda, and setting of an end date. So if we get the numbers in, that's more than I had hoped for.